In this video, I'm going to show you how to share interactive data views in the IGV Web app. Sharing data views in the IGV Web app is easy. If your data is available online, sharing a view of that data is as simple as sending a URL to an IGV Web app session. Now let's see some examples. Here I have a sequence alignment file with its corresponding index file locally on my computer. Let's say that I know I will want to share some IGV views of this sequencing data with my colleagues. To do this, I first need to make sure the data is accessible to them. One way to do this is to upload these sequencing data files to my Dropbox account. By default, with an unpaid account, Dropbox files can be viewed by anyone with a file URL. Note that Dropbox URLs are quite obscure, making it unlikely that someone will find the data without the URL. Now that my sequencing data is on Dropbox and accessible to my colleagues, let's open it up in IGV Web. To load the data from Dropbox, go to the Tracks menu, select Dropbox, enter your Dropbox credentials, and select your data. Note that if you're loading a BAM file, you will also need to load its corresponding index file ending in BAI at the same time. Great, now let's zoom in to get a look at the data. Okay, this looks like a SNP here. Let's right-click and sort by base. Then increase the track height so we can see more reads. I think this is an interesting SNP that my colleagues will want to see. To share this view with them, all I need to do is go to the Share menu. Here, there are a few options. First, I have the option of simply copying the data view URL to share it with others in whatever way I want. I can also use the Tweet and Email buttons, which provide shortcuts for sending the URL to others directly. The Embed option generates an HTML snippet that I can use to embed the view in a web page. And finally, the QR code creates a 2D barcode for the URL that can be included on a poster, for example. In all cases, the interactive data view will be the same. These different options are just for the purpose of convenience. Here I'll choose to copy the URL and email it to my colleagues. When they click on the link in the email, they'll be able to see and interact with the data view. The URL encodes all the information necessary to reproduce the view, but it does not copy the data. Instead, the URL provides a link to it. In this case, a link to the publicly available files in Dropbox. Note that this shared data view is a regular IGV session, with the exception that when the page is reloaded, it will return to the precise data view that the URL points to. But let's go back to the beginning and say that I'm not a Dropbox user, and I prefer keeping my data on a private Google Drive. In this case, I will need to explicitly share the data files with my colleagues on Google Drive. Here, I'll share the data with my colleague Kate. Now in IGV Web, instead of loading the files from Dropbox, I'll load them from Google Drive. Now I'll navigate to the view I want to share with Kate. And just like in the previous example, I'll copy the data view URL and send it to her. This time, however, when she enters the URL in her browser, she'll be prompted to provide her Google credentials. And then she'll be able to see and interact with the data view. The IGV Web app runs completely in the web browser. It's not connected to any backend IGV server. This means that loaded data only goes to the web browser on the user's local machine. Because of this, you can securely create shareable views of data hosted on a private intranet, even when using the public IGV app. The resulting links will only work within the private intranet where the data resides. For more information about the IGV Web app, click on the Help link.